The game starts from the Neolithic era, and you will have one hunting party you need to start with. In this era, your main goal can be seen in the Era Stars tree, that consists in growing your population till 5, discover 10 curiosities, and hunt down 3 wild animals. In order to grow your population in this era, you have to collect the food with your hunting party. To do so, you need to collect the curiosities that will appear randomly on the yields around the map. The second method is to defeat the wild animals that you have to find exploring the starting territory. After that, you will collect a specific amount shown in the unit composition. The food will be converted into a new hunting party unit, and it will be added in the free composition slot. To speed up the process, a good idea is to hunt bigger animals like mammoth. But in this case, you can risk losing one of your units, considering the damage that this animal can inflict. Therefore, before facing one of them, it is better to heal up as much as possible, and have at least 2 units in the hunting party. In order to attack any wild animal, you need to move your unit toward his location. Once enough close, will pop up the battle management menu. Here, you have 3 options. Retreat, that will disengage the attack. But in this case, your unit will receive a mouse that will decrease their movement points temporarily. Manual battle, that will allow you to decide how to resolve the fight. Or instant resolution, that will use the bar shown above to calculate who will win, and how much damage the surviving party will take. Keep in mind that manual battle is way better than instant. In fact, if you will manage it correctly, you will decrease the damage your units will take, and lower the chance to lose any units. So, let's see the early manual battle strategy. The first phase is the deployment, that will allow you to choose where to place your units at the beginning of the fight. You can choose specific yields to start from that are highlighted with blue. Each yield has its own type that can give bonus or malus status. For example, yields with rivers will give a malus called Crossing River, while the one with the forest has a bonus malus called In Forest. In this phase, you can right-click any yield to move the unit around, in order to check all of them for bonuses and maluses. To understand better what exactly are the specific bonuses or maluses will afflict your units, is enough to hover the mouse upon the status name, and it will pop up its description with all the details you need to know. Once chosen the desired location, press End Deployment to start the battle. If you don't want to micromanage in the battle, you can enable automatic battle at any moment, and the AI will do the work at your place. The cool thing is that if you want to stop the process, because you feel that the AI is making some mistakes, you can stop it also at any time, and start managing the battle by yourself. While fighting wild animals, a good strategy is to start with full health. In case your army is composed of one unit, start the fight defending yourself the first turn. This will lower the damage you will take from the first attack, applying to it the defending buff and decreasing the probability to lose your unit, and giving you an advantage in the next turn attack. Then, in the next 2 turns of the fight, attack normally. Well, in case your army is composed of multiple units, start from attacking with both. Then, in the next turn, use the defend action on the one that gets targeted by the enemy. Keep in mind that in case you want to win or lose the fight in a specific amount of actions, your team and the enemy will be moved far away one from the other. Plus, your team will receive the same temporary malus like they retreated. So, if you want to finish the hunt, you have to search for the wild animal and fight it again. From the health regeneration standpoint, your units will heal up each turn even if you move them. But this is applied only in this era. Besides fighting the wild animals, another method to grow your population is to set up an outpost. To do so, select any of your hunting party units, and under the army actions, use the climb territory. Then place it where you want to set up your outpost. This action uses some influence and consumes all the movement points of your unit. Also, it takes several turns to be built, but once done, it will start to generate food. This will fill the population gain bar based on the amount of food points around the location. Once the barrier will fill completely, it will generate a new population unit in your outpost. Keep in mind that when you try to place down your outpost, the game AI will try to identify and highlight the best location of where to build it. The highlighted location takes in consideration the amount of food and industry point that the outpost will be able to gather. Higher the food output, faster your population will grow. But as told previously, to set up any outpost, you need first to have a specific amount of influence. This amount will rise for each claimed territory. The main way to gain influence point in this era is by hunting wild animals and collecting curiosities. Keep in mind that the other two goals ask you to do exactly this task. To complete all three tasks as soon as possible is a good idea to split your hunting party as soon as it will gain new units. To do so, select any team that has more than one unit. Then, select the unit you want to detach from the team. This will show some interaction you can do with this specific unit. Use the transfer and send this unit on a different yield. As a result, the chosen unit will be detached from the party. Keep in mind that to move the unit, your team needs to have at least one available movement point. This action, in fact, will consume one movement point of the moved unit in order to move away from the team. Knowing all of this, you will be able to fulfill all the era goals. Once any of the era star will be completed, you will receive a message that tells you that you can advance in the next era or remind you later about it. Keep in mind that it is better to complete all three goals before advancing in the next era, because each star will also give you fame points. And the only winning condition in this game is the amount of fame you will be able to collect compared to your opponents. Therefore, it is quite important that you will get as much of them as possible in each era. But once you are ready to advance in the Ancient Era, click on the Empire icon that will bring the Culture section menu. This happens only if you completed at least one goal in this era. Each culture has its own perks, unique buildings and units. But this topic will be discussed in more details in the next video that will cover the Ancient Era. If you're interested in it, check the end screen video, or access directly the playlist that covers all the eras of the game. Also, if you have any problems during your gameplay and have any questions, leave a comment and you will receive the answer to any of your questions.